Sebastian's sleeping, so I'm trying to talk a little bit quieter, hopefully not too quiet. But if you're new to my channel, definitely make sure to hit that subscribe button. And today we are going to dive into your guys' paranormal stories. I know I like sent the message on Instagram, posted it on my story a while ago for this. I'm finally doing it. And if you guys were not included in this round, don't worry, this will not be the only video with it. And if you haven't sent in your paranormal stories but you want to be a part of this, definitely make sure to email me, or you can even shoot me a message on Instagram or even TikTok. So, and if you're not following me on there yet, I will be posting a bunch more, so definitely make sure to go do that. I have them on my iPad. So this is the first one, and this one is from Peyton. Now, she said, okay, so this happened October 19th, 2019. So me and my mom were getting ready to go see Taylor Swift at the Hollywood Bowl, and I was getting ready in her bathroom. We're living at the North Glen apartment, and if you can picture my mom's bathroom, you can see out in the living room because we both had master bedrooms. And I was looking at my costume, and all of a sudden I see this person walk past, and I go, okay. I go, Mom, did you see that? And she goes, what? And I told her what I saw, and she went to go see what it was. And there was nothing there, of course. And what I saw was what looked like a person dressed in a white clown costume, but there was no ruffle thing on top. Yeah. I mean, I'm not scared of clowns, but I don't think I would enjoy seeing a clown spirit. I wonder if, like, it was somebody that passed close by her apartment. So that's very curious. So the next one, she wanted to remain anonymous, so I completely respect that. And if you guys do send in your stories and you want to remain anonymous, definitely make sure to specify that, just so then I don't cross any boundaries with you guys. So, she said, about a year ago, I contacted a dead family member with a Ouija board. My mom miscarried before I was born, and I wanted to connect with the baby that I never was able to see. I started by asking if anyone was there. It said, yes. I asked if I could speak to my dead sibling. It said, yes. I asked the baby who its parents were, and it spelled out my mom and dad's names. I asked if it was a boy or a girl. It spelled out boy. I asked him how old he was when he died. He spelled out 12 weeks gestation. I started crying. I asked him if he was in heaven, if he missed mommy and daddy, if he loves me. And if he's waiting for us in heaven, he answered yes to all of the above. I told him in tears, I love you. I also asked him what he would have wanted to be named, and he spelled out William. I said goodbye and ended the session. It was the most powerful session that I've ever done. That is such a powerful session. I don't know how I would react to that, honestly. But it is amazing that you were able to connect with your brother. Like, when somebody miscarries, it's so hard on every member of the family, especially the woman carrying it. And that is such an amazing experience that you actually got to communicate with them. I believe that they never really leave us. So this one is from Lorena. I hope I pronounced your name right. And she said, so for the past little while, I've had this overwhelming feeling that something's watching me. So I've been having trouble sleeping. When I do, I have nightmares. I'm always in the same position on my back with my hands underneath my butt, like I can't get them out. Like, just like laying on it, I'm assuming. This happens like every 2 days. I can't stand it, and I am working on telling it to leave. The last nightmare I had was with a child screaming in my closet calling for help. Eerie. So I definitely got that feeling where something is watching me. I actually get that feeling quite a lot, but if it is a negative energy, it could be trying to trick you with the whole child screaming in your closet, because a lot of times demonic beings disguise themselves as something so innocent as a child. So definitely keep me posted on that. So look who it is. So this back so you can be in a little bit more. So Sebastian woke up. Say hi, buddy. Say hi. Wave? No? He's still a little groggy. So the last one I'm going to read actually came with audio, and I want to try to insert the audio. So if I can, first I'll read it and then I'll try to insert it if I'm able to. So she said, so this is from Demi. And she said this happened at the Eden Park gazebo in Cincinnati, Ohio. My best friend Jesse and I decided to do a girls' trip. We decided to check out the gazebo as we like to ghost hunt. We caught the audio on my phone using the Ghost Hunter M2 app. Right after you hear Jesse say, "Men suck," you can hear Mrs. Imogen say, mm-hmm. "I know." Mm-hmm. This is the story of the gazebo from Wikipedia. She included all this in her email. In 1925, popular Cincinnati attorney and bootlegger George Remus was indicted for thousands of violations of the Volstead Act. Convicted by a jury that made its decision in under 2 hours and given a 2-year federal prison sentence, he spent 2 years in Atlanta Federal Penitentiary for bootlegging. While he was in prison, Remus befriended another inmate and told him his wife, whom he adored, Imogen, had control over his money. The inmate was an undercover prohibition agent, Franklin Dodge. Dodge resigned from his job and started an affair with Imogen. The pair liquidated Remus's assets and hid as much of the money as possible, in addition to attempting to deport Remus and even hiring a hitman to murder Remus for $15,000. In addition, Remus's huge Fleischmann distillery was sold by Imogen, who gave her imprisoned husband only $100 of the multi-million dollar empire he created. Imogen then filed for divorce from Remus in late 1927. On the way to court on October 6, 1927, for the finalization of the divorce, Remus had his driver chase the cab carrying Imogen and her daughter through Eden Park in Cincinnati, finally forcing it off the road. Remus jumped out and fatally shot Imogen in the abdomen in front of the Spring House gazebo. So that's quite a story of what happened. I think it's pretty not okay for the undercover agent to do that, or any of those things. But let's listen to the audio. Let's see.
And then he had to kill you right before your divorce was finalized. I'm sorry. Okay.
So I'll try to insert that to see if I, like, it can be a little bit clearer for you guys. I can definitely hear a little bit coming through. I've never personally used that app, but I want to know what you guys think and what you hear in that audio.
You were just about to be rid of him. And then he had to kill you right before your divorce was finalized. I'm sorry. Okay.
And what do you guys think of all of the different paranormal stories that I've shared today?
You are the best!
I'm sure that the people that shared them with me would love to hear your guys' feedback as well. Any suggestions or, like, hypotheses, or however you say it, of what it might be. Definitely with the one with the child crying, I would definitely pay attention and be very cautious. As again, it's very common for demonic beings to disguise themselves as children, and it is probably best to try to get rid of the entity. So definitely keep me updated on that. And if you guys want me to share your guys's paranormal encounters and stories, or have any questions about any of them, definitely make sure to email me, or you can message me on Instagram or TikTok. And if you liked this video and you want me to continue sharing your guys's personal stories, definitely make sure to give this video a thumbs up. And if you are not subscribed yet, it would literally mean so much to me, you guys, if you could hit that subscribe button. I hope that you guys are doing well and looking forward to warmer weather if you are anywhere that's still kind of cold right now. Like today is, it's 20 something out. I don't like the cold. I like warmth. But until next time, I love you guys. Bye. Say bye, bud. Say bye. Wave. Wave. Can you blow kisses? Blow kisses. Castile says bye too. Bye, guys.